Jake Ludington here at Discover 2015 in London, and I'm here with Omer, and we're in the Hewlett Packard Labs booth, and you've got some graph analytics that are floating around on the screen behind us. Can you tell us what that's all about?
Yeah, so this is part of our bigger work on graph analytics, and actually part of the work on the machine. So when we look at the machine and its new architecture, and when you look at memory-driven computing, graph in general, but also other means of approaching data can be done differently, okay? When you have a system, a lot of the time you want to do transactional queries. In this case, we look at a social network. So transactional queries would be, I want to know who is the friends of this person, right? Just to get the wall of the people, or I like this comment, this is transactional. When you look at analytical queries, you can ask for very wide queries like, who are all the people that ask tag something in the beginning of December, or what's the shortest path between two people, and stuff like that. And these are very two different types of queries, which in many cases require different platforms altogether. And a lot of companies do that, but it costs a lot to have those two platforms.
So how does the machine allow you to combine those two types of queries into one system?
Yeah, so the idea is that since the machine gives you a memory-driven compute, you can actually have your data represented in a way that you can approach both the very large queries and also the smaller one. You no longer suffer from things like random access, which are very happens a lot in graphs, because when a person has a friend and this person has other friends, this will, in a disk, it will cause you to go to different places in the disk and cause you a very large hit on the performance. When you're in memory or you're in the fabric attached memory, you can approach different places in a very short time and allow you to do the context exploration, which is very important.
So you get efficiency around not hitting the disk every time because you're in the non-volatile RAM. Are there other efficiencies you get as well?
Yeah, so the efficiency is also about just having the same representation for different causes, right? So it's an efficiency of operations and of development. This has also to do with the idea of MDS, which is a way to a new way to persist your data inside the memory in a way that is not possible when you have it in a serial devices like disks and stuff like that.
So, and for people that may not be familiar, what is MDS?
MDS is a new way of representing your persistent data inside the non-volatile memory, which stands for managed data structures. And the idea there is that if you persist your data inside the memory, you actually don't have to do it in a serial way like you do in disk. You actually can store your data as their data structure objects. So this is another project, and I hope you'll talk with them as well.
All right. Well, this is very cool. Thanks, Omer.
Thank you.